And the real irony about everything with Brian Lenegal-Lightly Marshall is that I'm standing up for somebody who is Christ-like. So even for non-believers, you have nothing to lose with Brian because Christ would love him. If you can't believe that he's the reincarnation of Christ, even though it's completely uber obvious once you do the research, is your grandfather, father, brother, sister, mother out there fighting to cure AIDS for free? Fighting to bring colloidal silver and a empire to the world and serving the Queen of England to get off the throne? He had the oil spill cure when British Petroleum poured their poison into the ocean on purpose to depopulate. He served Lloyd's of London with the oil spill cure. He served the Queen of England to get the fuck off the throne in his real name, his real address, his real phone number. Now, I'm sorry, but you will not find anyone on this earth who is as rad and bad and smart and brave as Brian, and for free, with no army, mocked, ignored, etc. I'll tell you one thing. Whatever the afterlife stuff is, I earned points for sticking up for the man who is most like Christ for those who are non-believers. I know for a fact Brian is the reincarnation of Christ. I'd die for him right now. No ifs, ands, or buts, and I'm not a stupid person. I'm completely educated and informed. Brian on ABC News, curing HIV and AIDS and getting kicked out. I'll put the link below.
But people flocked to Bohain and Port Moresby for this unusual therapy.
That's Steve Bryan.
He told me that this product here, it can cure cancer, TB, HIV.
Yes, sir. That's Bryan.